the most important discoveries ever made by space telescopes. Over the last decades, and after the revolution brought by the general relativity theory, many space telescopes were launched. All of them have a precise goal, and there is always a huge team of physics researchers, engineers, astronomers, chemists, and opticians behind a good space telescope. Perhaps the most important reason why it is so important to have space telescopes is overcoming the atmosphere barrier. The atmosphere acts like a barrier in some ranges of wavelength, meaning that the light coming from objects in the universe is filtered by our atmosphere. The same precious atmosphere that gives us oxygen to breathe is the same that goes against us when it comes to observations of the universe. In this video, we present to you the most important discoveries ever made by space telescopes. 3, 2, 1, go! We'd like to start with one of the most beautiful pictures we have of the Cassiopeia A supernova. I mean, look at it. Isn't it amazing? This picture was taken by the Chandra X-ray Space Telescope. It is a telescope specially designed to detect X-ray emissions from very hot regions of the universe, such as exploded stars, clusters of galaxies, and matter around black holes. Because X-rays are absorbed by Earth's atmosphere, Chandra must orbit above it, up to an altitude of 139,000 kilometers or 86,500 miles in space. Speaking of Cassiopeia A, one can notice the blue, the violet, the red color, the spherical shape. Everything is fascinating. Even if it seems like a calm environment, it's actually an image of material going at supersonic speeds. This is actually what astronomers call a supernova remnant, which is the bloom of gas left over after a massive star went supernova some 340 years ago. It reveals a star turned inside out. While massive stars fuse the heaviest elements in their cores and lighter elements in surrounding onion-like layers, the Cassiopeia A explosion had flung clumps of iron to the outermost regions. The find suggests the star's contents mixed together right before or after its core collapsed. Or both. The existence of such supernova remnant was already known to astronomers, but in 1999 the Chandra Space Telescope identified a hot point source near the center of the nebula that has been identified as a black hole or neutron star. Speaking of black holes, with Chandra and XMM Newton Space Telescopes, astronomers could estimate black hole spin for the first time. In fact, by looking at the X-ray emissions from black holes, astronomers can see how close the gas comes to the event horizon. And roughly speaking, the closer it gets, the faster the black hole is spinning. Another important discovery made by the Chandra X-ray Observatory was the one regarding planet habitability. For example, if a planet receives a lot of X-rays from its host star, it is plausible that there's no life on it. Chandra's observations revealed, for example, that high-energy radiation irradiates the three Earth-sized planets in the TRAPPIST-1 system and has probably long ago stripped them of their atmospheres. The same has happened for Proxima Centauri. This makes them hostile planets. The discoveries made by Chandra concern the X-ray part of the electromagnetic spectrum, but of course we launch so many other space telescopes which are sensitive to other parts of it. For example, the so-called Spitzer Space Telescope was thought and built in order to observe infrared wavelengths. One of the most important discoveries carried out by Spitzer involved Saturn and its rings. In 2009, it spotted a giant ring of dust and ice particles. This ring was previously unknown to the scientific community, and it isn't visible to human eyes, i.e. we can't observe it in the visible domain because it is composed of tiny particles that reflect very little visible light from the sun. But it is warm enough to emit some heat in the form of infrared light, so Spitzer could see it. Spitzer also brought great news concerning black holes in distant galaxies. Black holes are actually black in the sense that we can't see them, but when material falls into it, it can heat up and shine, and the radiation they emit is mostly infrared. So what researchers did is to use Spitzer to look at some of the farthest, earliest supermassive black holes in galaxies. What they found was almost unbelievable. For a bunch of systems they studied, there was almost no dust in galaxy centers. This lack of dust meant that they had spotted supermassive black holes in the very early universe, where there weren't many heavy elements to aggregate and form dust. It was like having found the rest of the ancestors of all black holes, the Adam and Eve of all black holes. This find helped them understand how black holes and galaxies grow and evolve. Thank you, Spitzer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you have all been waiting for has come. We are going to talk about some of the most important discoveries of one of the most important space telescopes ever built, the Hubble Space Telescope. Since its 1990 launch, the Hubble Space Telescope has been dazzling the world with images of space and a deeper understanding of how the universe works. Compared to the vast 8 to 10 meter telescopes built on the ground, with even larger ones planned in the future, the 2.4 meter Hubble Mirror is relatively average for modern day research telescopes, and with optics that are approaching their third decade of use. However, it consistently outperforms many of the most advanced ground-based telescopes, and is still considered the pinnacle of optical and ultraviolet astronomy, with demand for its use in research greatly exceeding the available observing time each year. Hubble told us the age of the universe is something like 13.8 billion years. For comparison, the Earth is one-third younger. Hubble also discovered that Pluto, the dwarf planet in our solar system, has two moons orbiting around it. They're called Nix and Hydra, and with Charon, they form Pluto's moon system. Nix was imaged along with Pluto and its other moons by the New Horizons spacecraft as it flew by the Pluto system in July of 2015. Images from the New Horizons spacecraft reveal a large reddish area on Nix that is likely an impact crater. Hubble also helped us to create a 3D map of the dark matter, and therefore to better understand the universe we are living in. Dark matter is an invisible form of matter that makes up most of the universe's mass and creates its underlying structure. Dark matter's gravity drives normal matter, gas and dust, to collect and build up into stars and galaxies. Although astronomers cannot see dark matter, they can detect its influence by observing how the gravity of massive galaxy clusters, which contain dark matter, bends and distorts the light of more distant galaxies located behind the cluster. This phenomenon is called gravitational lensing. Hubble's uniquely sharp vision allowed astronomers to map the distribution of dark matter in space by using gravitational lensing. Large galaxy clusters contain both dark matter and normal matter. By observing the areas around massive clusters of galaxies, astronomers can identify warped background galaxies and reverse engineer their distortions to reveal where the densest concentrations of matter lie. The interesting thing here is that the universe appears to have five times more dark matter than previously thought. Do you have any idea how expensive it was? Hubble Space Telescope's original building cost of more than $2 billion US are exceeded only by the new James Webb Space Telescope, and the total running costs of Hubble have far exceeded $10 billion US. Last but not least, we would like to spend some time talking about the CHEOPS Space Telescope. CHEOPS is ESA's Characterizing Exoplanet Satellite. It is the first mission dedicated to studying bright nearby stars that are already known to host exoplanets in order to make high-precision observations of the planet's size as it passes in front of its host star. It will focus on planets in the super-Earth to Neptune size range, with its data enabling the bulk density of the planets to be derived, a first-step characterization towards understanding these alien worlds. It launched in December of 2019, and since then, it has amazed us with brand new discoveries that go further than we ever expected. It found incredible unique planetary systems. For example, in January of 2021, it detected six planets orbiting the star TOI-178. Actually, at first, they spotted just five of them, but scientists noticed that maybe there was something more. The system appeared to be in harmony. The team said that the theory implied that there could be an additional planet in this harmony. To check if their theory was, in fact, true, the team scheduled yet another observation with CHEOPS at the exact time that this missing planet would pass by if it existed. A few days later, the data clearly indicated the presence of the additional planet, and thus confirmed that there were indeed six planets in the TOI-178 system. CHEOPS is a really recent mission, and that means that we will hear a lot about its new discoveries in the upcoming years. It is one of the first space telescopes completely dedicated to finding exoplanets. In January of 2022, it revealed a rugby ball-shaped exoplanet. But how is it possible for a planet to have such a shape? Before finding out the answer to the question, be sure to like or dislike the video. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. We can understand it by thinking about tides. On coasts, tides determine the rhythm of events. If there is high tide, the way out to sea is cleared for boats. Instead, at low tide, boats remain on land. On Earth, the tides are mainly generated by the moon, but there are places in the universe where tides are much more extreme. This is exactly the case of the planet discovered by Cheops, WASP-103b. The planet orbits its star in just one day and is deformed by the strong tidal forces so drastically that its appearance resembles a rugby ball. This insane planet is located in the Hercules constellation, and it's huge. It's almost twice the size of Jupiter, and it's 1.5 times more massive. It orbits closer to its star than the Earth does with the Sun. This is why tides are extremely pronounced. However, measurements of its shape and tide could be inaccurate. That's why future observations with Cheops again, and maybe the James Webb Space Telescope, will be needed to decipher the details of the tidal deformation and internal structure of WASP-103b and comparable exoplanets. As you can see, the advent of space telescopes extend our knowledge of the universe, and now our horizons are wider than ever. As technology improves, we will find more and more amazing discoveries. It's just a matter of time. Piece after piece, we are trying to complete the puzzle of the entire universe. The question is, will we ever be able to complete it? That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What was your favorite discovery? Let us know in the comments below.